In this video, I want to cover the last type of email providers. So as we're going through these videos, the providers will become a little bit harder to use and will have less features, but they will become more private, more secure, and therefore more anonymous. So in the previous lecture, we had a look on privacy-focused email providers such as ProtonMail. They were great, as they don't track you, they keep no logs, they use encryption and all that good stuff. The only problem with them is that they operate both on the clear and on the darknet. They are proper known companies, and therefore, sometimes they comply with court orders and might be influenced by agencies and so on. Now, the email providers that I want to show you in this lecture, they come with all of these great features of the privacy-focused mail providers, so they come with no tracking, no logs, require no personal information and all that. And they operate fully from the darknet, so they don't have servers on the ClearNet, and even if they have ClearNet websites, they redirect you to the darknet website. They're less likely to be influenced by agencies and so on, because all of their servers are in the darknet, so all of them are running as onion services, therefore by default they benefit from Tor's anonymizing and privacy features. They all use encryption, and therefore they are more secure, more private, and therefore they are more anonymous. Now, there are a lot of darknet email providers. I'll include links to lists in the resources of this lecture. You can go through them and see which one you like the most. As usual, do your own research, read the privacy policy, and pick the one you like the most. In this lecture, though, I'm going to show you two examples of these mail providers. The first one is Elude. It's pretty cool. Like I said, keeps no track, no logging, all that cool stuff. It also uses end-to-end encryption, and your emails are stored in personally encrypted storage. So that's really, really nice. Now, before I go and use this, both of the services that I'm going to show you today do not require JavaScript. Therefore, we can go ahead and set our security settings to the highest. We had to keep it at safer when we were using ProtonMail because it requires JavaScript. But for both of the services that we're going to use today, they do not require JavaScript. Therefore, we can set our security to the highest, and they should still work and function as expected. Signing up to this is very simple. All you have to do is go to sign up. Now, like I said, I will include a link to this in the resources of the lecture, so don't worry about that. It's going to ask you for your name. Again, use your fake identity. So I'm going to set it to John Wick. Put a username. So I'm going to set it to JNWK7. Set a password. Solve the CAPTCHA. And click on register. So it doesn't get any simpler than this. When you're done, it's telling us we succeeded. We have the email now. And we can just go ahead and log in. So I'm going to log in with my username, put my password, fill the CAPTCHA. Now it's going to ask you to verify your email. You can do this using any of the other services that I covered before, or you can just skip the verification and go straight to your account. Now that I'm in my account, I'm going to go to the email login to go to my inbox. And I'm going to use the text on the interface. And perfect. As you can see, you get a normal inbox that is very easy to use, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it. But I want to highlight a major feature of this email provider. See, when it comes to darknet email providers, not all of them allow you to send emails to darknet and clearnet addresses. So, Elude is one of these email providers which allow you to communicate with both clearnet and darknet addresses. So, as a test, let me first of all send an email to a ClearNet address to a Gmail address. So this is my other Gmail account. Now you should never do this in real life scenarios. You should never communicate with your own ClearNet addresses because this can be used to link you and to know who you are. But for now, I'm just trying to show you that this email provider works with both ClearNet and DarkNet addresses. So I'm just going to say this is a test to a ClearNet email address. You can also send attachments if you want, but we're going to keep this the way it is. I'm going to send it. And if I go to my Gmail address that I sent this to, as you can see, we got the message. It's telling us that this is a test to a ClearNet address. And I can reply, let's just say it works. And if we go back here, go to the inbox, refresh it. Perfect. As you can see, we got the response. If we click on that, it's saying it works, so everything is working as expected, and we can use this account to send emails to both ClearNet and Darknet addresses. Now, this is one example of Darknet email providers. The other example that I want to show you is called TorBox. Like I said, I will include links to this in the resources. And the main difference between TorBox and Elude is that TorBox is completely isolated from the ClearNet. This makes it a little bit more private because it literally prevents you from communicating with anyone on the ClearNet, therefore increasing your privacy and therefore increasing your anonymity. Also, like I said, the more examples that I show you, the less features they will have and the more anonymous they are. So this email provider has less features and you'll see that, but like I said, it'll be more private and more anonymous. So, let's click on sign up to sign up and you'll see this is again very, very simple. We'll set a name. So again, John Wick. Pick an email. So our email is going to be jnwk7 and it'll be at this address .onion. And we're going to set a password and solve the captcha. And perfect. The email is done. This is it. You can store it in a text file so you can remember it. And now we can go ahead, click on webmail login to log in, put the name and the password. And perfect, we're logged in right now. As you can see, the interface is even simpler in here. If you wanted to write a message, you can click on compose. Let me show you if I sent this to my Gmail email address. And say test and click on send. You'll see that this will actually be refused. So as you can see, it's telling us that this did not get sent because we are trying to communicate with a ClearNet email address. However, if I try to send something here to the Elude email, so this was jennyck7@elude.n, keep everything the same. If I click on send, you'll see I'll get no error messages. And if I go to Elude and check my inbox, you can see I have a message coming from my TorBox address. And if we go in, we can see the message content. Now, Elude and TorBox are just two examples of Darknet email providers. Like I said, I just wanted to show you two different examples, as like I said, Elude allows you to communicate with both ClearNet and Darknet addresses, where TorBox can only communicate with Darknet addresses. So, again, do your own research, read about both of them, see which one suits you best and fits your threat model and fits your needs, and use the one that is best for you. And like I said, I'll include links to all of these and more in the resources of this lecture.